राजेश, ओके, सो द लास्ट क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द व्हाट इज एंड्रॉइड, सो व्हाट आर द रिक्वायरमेंट्स वी नीड टू डेवलप द एंड्रॉइड एप्लीकेशन. ओके, सो आई विल आई थिंक यू यू हैव सीन माय वीडियोस. हैव यू सीन दोस वीडियोस?
One video, right?
वन वीडियो, यस.
Yeah, I see. I got.
ओके, so if you want to if you want the first class also, then I will let you, I will later on I will explain to you, because today we are it is a common class for me. So just how to install the, how to set up the environment of Android to develop the Android application. Okay, so for that so I'm explaining again. So I'm sharing my screen. So can you tell me about yourself? Just I wanted to know.
Yes. Hi. This is my name is Rajesh. I done my master's. I'm doing my master's from electronics and communication engineering. And
Okay.
my BTech background is also from electronics.
Okay.
I want to learn the Android, and I want to become the Android developer. Yeah, this is like my intro.
Okay. Yeah.
You have any question, can you tell me? I can.
Yeah, okay, no problem. Just okay, no problem. Yeah, that's it. So I'm sharing my screen. So are you able to see my screen?
Before I have seen, yeah, I'm able to see.
Yeah. So today we are going to discuss about Android environment setup. Okay. So how to set up the Android environment? It is very simple. Just we have to follow the four steps. The first step is we have to install Java software. Okay. The second step, you have to install Eclipse. Okay. I think these two is enough to develop the Java applications. Okay. But I want to develop Android applications, so I need the Google's provided Android software. So that is nothing but Android SDK. SDK is nothing but software. Hello.
Sorry for the interference.
Yeah, okay. So SDK nothing but software development kit. So we need one SDK also. And the last step is ADT. ADT is nothing but Android development tools. If we have these four items, so we can ready to start the development of Android applications. Okay, so in the last session me and Abhijit was working to set up this environment. So you can share your screen, then we can explain so how it was. Abhijit, you can share your screen now.
Just a minute.
Yeah.
Can you make me the presenter? Because without.
Yeah. Okay. Yes.
Can you see it?
Yes. So in the last session, so this is Eclipse we have, and we have the Java also. See here, there are two icons. Can you give me the control also, so I can.
Yeah, just a minute.
Yeah.
Is it admin or is it SS client? It's admin, right?
It is SS client. Yes. Yes. So these are the two icons which are not available with the Eclipse. So if I am mouse over on it, so it is showing some. What is the name it is showing?
Download.
100 SDK manager, and this is a AVD manager. So these are the two tools. These are the development tools which is provided by Google. So how you will get these two? Okay, it is very simple. It is a go to help. Click on help once.
Yeah, just a minute. It's in. Just a minute.
Go to install new software. Yeah. So here, see, suppose if I want to add
I just minimize this. Go to now we can see it clearly.
Yeah. So for this development tools, how can I add means? So we can add by using this window. So see here, add button is there. Okay. Otherwise, I will share my screen. Then I think it is easy. Okay. Then.
Canada.
Yeah. So now, are you able to see my screen now? Yeah. So this is a empty Eclipse. It is having nothing, just Eclipse and Java setup. So I can able to create the Java applications. So I want to develop mobile Android mobile applications. So for that, I need to add the plugin. So how can I add the plugin? Simply go to help, and there is the option install new software. Okay, and here one add button is there. If you click on add, so it will ask you the software address. Okay, this address is provided by Google. So that is nothing but ADT plugin. So how can we know the location of this ADT? Simple, go to the Google and search for ADT plugin URL. Okay. So see this one, the fourth item, ADT plugin for Eclipse. So this is the location where the software is available. The ADT software is available. Just you have to copy and paste these things. Paste this address. Here. And you can give any name, like this is a plugin name. You can give any name, like I am giving the ADT like this. So just click on OK. Okay. Then the related software, the ADT software, will be downloads. So after that, you have to restart your application. Then you will see these two icons. So one is the 100 SDK manager. This is the 100 virtual device manager. Okay. So it's very simple. So I'm going with the SDK manager. So when I'm clicking on the SDK manager, so just now I told you the third point. So I need a SDK. SDK is nothing but software development kit. So Android releases so many SDKs from the starting to till date. For example, it starts with the cupcake, donut, eclairs, froyo, KitKat. Now we are using Lollipop. These are all the SDK version. Suppose if you want to work on some specific SDK, you can download the specific SDK. So how can you download the SDKs? How can you uninstall the SDKs? Let's see. It is by using this icon, this SDK manager will take care of installing and uninstalling the SDKs. So how it will do? Simple, this is a window, SDK manager window. So if you observe from top to bottom, for example, I'm taking one example, like see, this is a 105.0.1. okay, this is one SDK, and 104.4, this is a KitKat version. This is also one SDK. These are all SDKs which are available. Okay, suppose if you want to work with the 4.4.2, so just expand this one, you can download the SDK. So I have downloaded SDK platform already, and these two files you have to install. Why this one I will explain later on. Okay, and also you have to install this SDK tools. Okay, this is a 19 level, these are the levels, and some is supporting files like Android support library. You have to install the support library. These are the things you have to download. You can download any number of SDKs, not only one SDK. If you want to download one more, just click this one. Okay, whatever you wish, you can select the items, and there is a option we have like install one package. If you want uninstall, suppose if I want to uninstall this SDK, just select it, and it will comes with a delete one package. Okay, you can install, you can uninstall, whatever, you can do both the things. Okay, so for tutorial purpose I am download only one SDK because it takes more memory, that's why I am taking only one SDK. And this is the AVD. AVD is nothing but Android virtual device. Virtual device. What do you mean by virtual? Can you tell me virtual? What is a virtual? Hello, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so what do you mean by virtual? Any idea?
No.
No idea. Okay. So while developing this Android applications, so we are going to use virtual machines. Virtual machines, and what is the difference between virtual machines and real machines? See, virtual and real. It is very simple. A real device is nothing but which we are using the mobile phones. The mobile phone nothing but real devices. You can run your application by using the real device. Sometimes maybe the real devices are not available. So how can you run your program? So the Android people has provided the virtual devices for us. So it's very similar to real device, but it is a software. It's not a hardware. So these are the virtual devices. Okay. So we can create any virtual device. For example, I want to run my application in, for example, my screen size should be 480x800. So I want to buy a real device with the same dimensions. Suppose I want to run my application in the phones from the Google. Suppose I want to use 800x1200. Suppose if the dimension is that type of dimension, I want to buy one more device. So I need to buy so many devices to check the application is working properly or not. So this is very headache thing. So instead of that, the people, Android people has given a chance as to create the virtual devices. So you can create any virtual devices. So by using that, you can run your applications. So I will tell you how to. So how to create the virtual device? Let's see. It's very simple. So I'm clicking on this virtual device manager. See, this is if you want to create the device, you can create. Okay. This is it is asking for the device name. So AVD name, you can give any name. So this second option, see, this is very very important. So I want to create the virtual device. There are so many options. If you want to create the Nexus phone, you can use the Nexus phone. If you want to create the 5.4 inch phone, 5.1 inch phone, you can take anything. So these are the virtual devices. Okay, so I am taking one simple one like a Nexus. Suppose Nexus 5, I am taking Nexus 5 or Nexus 4, you can take anything, other one Nexus S. So I'm taking this one, and you have to give this target. Target means which version, which SDK you are using. So I'm using SDK 19. I have three SDKs, SDK 8, SDK 19, SDK 20. So I'm using 19 level. Okay. And you have to give this is the CPU. CPU is nothing but a processor. Which processor you want to use? You can use this depend on the platform. Sometimes it is working with the ARM, sometimes working with some devices are working with the ARM. So I will let you know later on. So no problem. Don't worry at this point. Okay. And you have to select the keys. You have to select the skin. Skin means nothing but you can take any skin. So 400, 800. Okay. And the front camera, back end, no need, all these things. Just you have to create the AVD. So actually, what is AVD? You are not understanding, I think so. AVD is nothing but just the AVD. Okay. AVD is nothing but this is just like mobile phone, but it is not real phone. It is a virtual device.
This is
just
screen,
right? Yeah, this is a. For testing purpose, we have created one virtual device. It is very similar to phone. We have the menu option, we have the back option, calling option, and everything. If you click on this one, you will see some applications also there, which are comes with the by default with the under software, like calendar, camera, browser. All these things comes with the. This Android operating system. So in this way, we have to create the virtual devices. You can create any virtual device. Okay. So this is the AVD. Any doubts so far?
No.
No, not clear. Okay. Now I'm going to create one simple. First application, Hello World application. So you can understood that how to create the application, so how to run the application. Okay. So for that, in Java, how can we create the project? Any idea? And one more thing, Rajesh, you know Java?
No, sir, I don't know Java. I want to speak. I want to ask you about this. Like, can I learn or can I manage? I have to learn everything. I'm very new. I have to learn Java and I have to learn user interface too. I'm from electronics background, right?
But Java is compulsory for this Android. If you know Java, then only you understood.
Okay. If not, it's not possible, right?
But possible means it will be difficult for you. I think so.
Okay.
So then, what you will do?
Can you suggest me, can I take this class or
not? Because the thing is, actually, we are going to write the code in the Java only. We are using Java only for this Android. So if you have some basic knowledge in Java, then you can understand. Like, OOPS concept, at least
yeah.
You can ask.
Maybe. OOPS what concept. Is
yeah.
Yeah.
So what
can
is inheritance?
Yeah. Okay. See, I can tell you what concepts I am familiar in the OOPS. Like I am familiar with the user interface. And well, give me a second, please. I will. I can tell you. 1 second, please. In the OOPS, I'm familiar with these concepts. Creating frames, labels, buttons.
Mm-hmm.
Can you hear me?
Yes.
Yeah, buttons, canvas, scroll bars. Like these are the user interface components.
Okay.
And the graphics part.
Okay.
And then.
Actually, those are not the OOPS concepts, actually. Those
okay.
are different. Yeah. Okay, anyway, okay, let's see. So, I think you will understand that you have some basic knowledge, right?
Yes, I have basic knowledge in terms of C.
But you, from your side, you have to give some extra effort for this Java also. You can, so then you, your side you have to work on Java also, not only Android, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so I'm going with the simple examples, no problem, don't worry. Step by step I will tell you.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so now time's comes like now we are going to create the first application. So how to create the application? In Java, how can we create the application? File, new, Java project, right?
Yes.
The same way, there is one more option, Android application project, okay? So select this one, okay? And click on enter. See, are you able to see the screen?
Yes.
Yeah. Abhijit, are you there? Hello?
Yes, I am there, but yeah. I cannot see the Android application project in my file.
Now?
Yeah, there is just Java project, there is no Android application project.
Uh-huh, in your, okay, I think, okay. You are not able to see the Android application project?
Yeah.
But you have downloaded that, right?
Yeah, I did download.
Okay, mm-hmm. So, okay, so after this one we will see it, okay?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, okay. So this is application name, so I can give some, what the application name, simple, I can take Abhijit and Rajesh, so I'm taking like this. So this is our application. So this is application name. The project name and application name both are same. Okay. So the third one is very, very important. This is a package name. See here, by default, it is coming with com.example.abhijit and Rajesh application. Okay. So it is following nothing but my domain address. Suppose www.google.com. So they are changing into reverse way, like com.example.something. So if you are working in an organization, so your package name should be with your organization names. Like suppose your organization is google.com. Suppose www.google.com. Then you can use the package name as com.google.application and the package name and the package name whatever you can give. So why this one actually? So I'm giving here a simple com.xapp. Okay, I'm giving Abhijit and Rajesh. I'm giving this is the package name, my package name. So actually, why I'm giving this package name? Because if you know the Google Play Store, there are so many applications, right?
Yes.
And there are so many developers are there. Suppose I'm creating an application. My application name is simple Hello application, and you're also developing the name with the Hello application. We both are having the same application, and we are going to the Play Store to upload our application. I'm uploading and you're also uploading. There are two applications. Then there will be it shows the message like the application is already existed with this name. So you can change the name. But you don't want to change the name. Okay? So how the difference will be, how the Google Play Store will find out the uniqueness between these two applications? This is simple by using this package. So the package name should be completely different from one application to another application. Then it will consider as this is a something different application, this is a something different application. Okay. By these packages, the uniqueness will be comes. And also, one thing, it comes with your company name, right? So every time if you are searching with this package, your company, whatever the, your company is releasing the application, it will comes with these packages. Okay, by seeing this package name, we can understood like, okay, this company is releasing this application. Okay, that's why we are using this package name. This is very, very important. Got it? End ups?
No.
No. Okay. So this is the fourth step. Minimum required SDK. Minimum required SDK means. So I told you there are so many SDKs from starting 2.2 to now 5.1. So minimum means, suppose if I am taking minimum as 4 version. Suppose I am taking minimum as 4. So I am developing my application by using 4. Okay. So the application is running from the 4 to 5 only, not from 3 or 2. Okay. The minimum is 4. That is the last level. So you can't go backward. Okay. So if you set the 2.2 as a minimum level and you are developing using 4.4, but you can move from 4.4 to 2.2 also, the backward. Okay. Minimum is nothing but the last level, the very last level. So for that I am choosing only, instead of 2.2 I am choosing 4.4 only. Because why I am choosing, because nowadays no one using 2.2. Okay, most of the people updated to 4 KitKat version. So minimum is 4 is enough. So it will be work for 5.1 also. Okay. And target. Target means you can target on specific SDK. Suppose if I am targeting 4.4.2 like KitKat. So whatever the available, whatever the features available in 4.4.2 like KitKat, those software, those will be available to my this target SDK. Okay, those features will be available directly. So I am using this one for KitKat version and compile with. So what is the compiler?
Which runs the program?
No. What do you mean by compiler? Compiler is a software program like which is converts from high level to low level language. Okay. So if you want to compile, which SDK you want to compile? I want to compile with the same 19 level. Okay. And the theme is, I'm taking none. So I will tell you this one also. So this is we have filled all these forms and there is one option. Next, we are no need to do anything. This is a window configure project. There is already some selected boxes, no need to do anything. And going to next. Say this is a important one. Somebody is speaking. Can you? Hello.
The worst is wrong. Applications are ready. Save to line pop up.
Hello.
From Amjit, I think so.
Can you? There is some noise is coming. Yeah. So this is the next step. The step is configure launcher icon. So every when you are installing the application comes with icon. Suppose if you are downloading WhatsApp, so WhatsApp is having one icon, right? The F is a symbol. So you can select the icon. So here you can browse the icon and then you can select the icon whatever you wish. Okay. For example purpose, by default we are getting one icon. This is the Android icons. Okay. This is a M, H, and I will tell you what is M, H, all these things, okay? And simply go for next. Okay. So in the Java, what is the starting point of execution? There should be a main class, right?
main class.
And main class should have one main method, nothing but public static void main. That is a starting point of the Java project. Here also we have to take one class, Java class, but here we are calling it as activity in Android. Okay, I am taking the blank activity. So my activity name is main activity, and it comes with one layout. So what is the layout here? Okay, suppose if you are downloading Facebook, you are opening the Facebook, you will see some data, right? Suppose some lists are there. That is nothing but a layout. Suppose if you are clicking on comment, so you are clicking on the layout file, not the activity. Okay, but background, whatever the logic, whatever the business logic for the clicking on comment button, it should be in the activity. Okay, don't worry about this thing also. I will later on, you will understand the first time only, that's why it will be confused.
Okay.
And I'm clicking on finish. Now my application is created. My application is Abhijit Rajesh application. And this is the project structure. Okay. In the Java, what is the Java project structure? This is the Java project structure. Simple, we have the source and we have the package, default package, we have the all these classes, and comes with one GRE system library. This is nothing but supporting library. This is simple Java project, but it comes, when it comes to the Android, this is the Android structure. I will tell you one by one what it is exactly. Just now see what is the application, how to create the application and what it is. So it comes with the main activity and this layout. So layout is coming with the hello world. Okay, so I want to run this application, so the output will be come like this, hello world. So how to run the application? Simple, right? There is an option, run as, and click on run Android application. Okay, when you click on Android application, after that go to emulator. Your application will comes here. So if you want to see whether the application is installing or not, so you can see in the console your application installing application and got the success. So where is your application? This is your application. Okay, Abhijit and Raj application. So I'm clicking on this one. So this is a hello world. Okay, so in this way, this is a simple way how to create the application and how to run the application. So how to create the EBD, these are the things. So I will give you a full description once again. So the first step is you have to download SDKs. Second step is you have to create the EBD. Okay, after these things, just create the Android application. How you create the application, the go to file, go to the new, and the create Android application. There it will ask you the application name and the package name and the SDK version, which SDK version you want. Okay, and the icon. Then click on finish. Then you will get the application. And how to run the application is very, very simple. Just right click on this and click on run as Android application. Okay, any doubt so far? Hello?
Yeah.
No, no doubts. Okay, this is the setup of Android environment. So now we will set up in your system. So You can share your screen so I will see what is the problem. Okay. So I'm making you as a presenter.
Can you see my screen?
Yes. So go to file.
Yeah. Oh, sorry, just a minute.
Okay. New. If you are not able to see, go to other. I think first time it is not showing.
Where is
file, in the file, file new. Sorry, sir. File new.
Okay. Oh, yeah, okay.
Yeah, other, last one. Yes.
In Android?
There is Android and there is Android application file. Click on that one. Yeah. Next. Click
okay.
on next. Yeah. Give the name, any name.
Either.
Yeah. Change the package also, you can change the package, otherwise let it be your wish. Remove the example, just to put it com.curiosity. Okay. Yeah. Go to minimum SDK. Select the right side. Which software you downloaded? 19, right?
Yeah, 19.
But you have selected 14. Select 19.
Okay, yeah. I think there is some problem with the project name.
Why? Yeah. The project with the name already exists. So you are taking...
Yeah, it's take, the package name is the same.
Okay. The project name, change the application name also. Okay. Both should be same. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Select the target SDK also. Target SDK as a 19 level. Okay.
The theme is not right.
Next one, compile with 19 again.
There are no options in this one.
No options, okay, let it be. Theme is none, okay. Next.
Yeah.
Go to next again. Go to next. This is a by default, it will take this Android icon.
Okay.
Click on next, blank activity. Next, finish. What is that? Errors, running building.
Null point expansion.
Exception. Building workspace has encoder problem. Click on OK. What is the problem? Click on next. Finish again. Same problem. I think there is a problem in the workspace. Okay, can you click on OK and cancel it? Close this
okay.
Window.
Okay.
Now change the workspace, go to files. Switch the workspace and you can choose another one.
There is only, okay.
Okay, you can change one more, you can create one more folder. No, no, there only, you can create one more folder.
Go okay.
Yeah. You can write any name like Android workspace or whatever.
Okay, yeah, I just named it the untitled folder.
Close this window. Welcome. Close welcome.
Should I do the same process again, or should I open the file?
File. Go
Can
to
I open
file.
The file, or should I repeat?
No, no. Go to file again.
Okay.
There will be option new. Okay. 100 application project.
Sure.
Yeah, do the same thing. We are 19. Okay. None. Next, finish. What is there? Okay, under resource manager and project maintenance. Okay, do one thing, cancel this one, oh, click on OK and cancel.
Okay.
Cancel. Go to SDK manager. Where is SDK manager?
Oh, I think it's in.
It will be available on the toolbar only. Right?
Yes, I think it's.
Maybe go to view. It will, maybe it will hide somewhere. Show view, window show view,
window.
Go to other. Android. Is there SDK manager?
No.
Type SDK manager there. SDK manager. Type.
No, I can't find SDK manager here.
But yesterday there, it should be. It has there, right?
Just now it was there.
Okay.
I think it's if change the workspace, does it change the SDK manager? Because if you open in the previous
file in the new file.
Okay, otherwise change the old workspace, then we will see whether this is coming. Change it to old workspace.
Yeah, now it is there.
Go to SDK manager now. Okay, this do one thing. Go to 5.1.1. There is SDK platform. You can uninstall that one.
This one? Should I uninstall it?
Can you uncheck all these things? There is an option install 15 package means 15 items are selected. So you can uncheck all these things first.
Okay.
Uncheck all.
Just
Now everything is clear. Now we uninstall this SDK platform 5.1.1. Just select it and delete. Okay.
Okay.
And Okay, now close this. Now delete that file and create again. Right click and delete. Yeah, delete file from space. Yes, and now select one more time. Okay, here it is not showing any.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, so cancel it. Cancel this one. No, cancel this one. Again, go to SDK manager. Maybe we are missing something. That's what is not showing. What is the missing part? You have downloaded SDK build tools also. Yeah, this is right, and we are going down. SDK 19th extras we have. Okay, download this one. Download the Google support library. You have to install.
That's already okay.
You have to uncheck all these things, the above one.
Okay.
Now just select that one and Google repository. Select this 19 level also. The third one.
Which one?
The second one. After the support library, the Google Play services are there. There is a Google's repository.
Yeah. Okay.
Go down. Nothing is there, right?
Yeah, that's it.
Okay. Now install these two packages. Yeah, this is done. So close this window and restart the Eclipse again. I think it is better to restart because some changes have been done.
I can't select compile with.
Still is not showing.
Yeah.
But it should be okay. I don't know why this problem is coming. I never get this type of problem. Okay, no, it won't create. So okay, I will do. I will work on it.
Sure.
Tomorrow I will let you know. Okay.
Sure.
Okay. This is the today's. So Rajesh, you can also try to set up the environment. Okay. Hello.
Yeah.
Are you there?
Yeah, first you explained right how to set up it.
Yeah, so tomorrow just the first 15 minutes we will start, we will begin the early, first 15 minutes early. So we will cover those things, then Abhijit will join with us, okay?
Tomorrow
you can join. Our class is starting at 8:30, right? You can join at 8:45. You will join 8:30, okay?
Yeah, that's Indian time, not Indian time. It is different.
Yeah, it is Indian time. And
Indian time 8:30.
Yeah. So you can join 15 minutes earlier. I mean 15 minutes. You can join after 15 minutes. Abhijit, you. Huh?
Yeah. Sure,
so until
sure.
I will explain him how to set up what is this everything. Okay.
Yeah, sure.
Okay.
Is 32-bit system okay or
is 64-bit? Anything is okay, but you have to download the 32-bit version as it is. Okay. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, that's it for yeah.
Is it possible for me to learn Java in this
program?
Can you?
I didn't get that. Can you speak a bit loud?
Will it be possible to learn Java and can I Android too? Both is, will it be possible for me to learn first Android and then come to first Java and then come to Android?
You can learn parallelly Java and Android also. I think better to do the parallelly because these two things are very bit similar, so you can do the parallelly. Okay. Okay, right.